Hi, I'm Spencer with the Tennis Warehouse Racquet Review. This is the Donnay Pro 1. Donnay brings back the Pro 1 in an updated fashion. Along with a sleek black and silver look, a slightly larger head size with Zincore technology offers increased forgiveness and comfort. This one comes in at 11.5 ounces strung, has a swing weight of 327, and an open string pattern of 16 by 19. Let's see how it fared with our testers. We're here with Chris Edwards. Chris, the new Pro 1, definitely anticipated from the market out there. How does it compare to the Pro 1 International that you used to play with? And what are your thoughts?
It's a really different racket. I mean, I used the Pro 1 back in the day, and this one's a very different racket. That one was a really flexible racket, much heavier. This one, it's lighter, it's faster. I think it's better suited to the modern game. I really like the open string pattern. And then, you know, as you just read the specs out, it really does offer a nice fit. It's light and fast feeling, yet, but there's enough swing weight and mass behind the ball for good power. I wouldn't say it's like UTEC IG Radical Pro kind of power, but it's getting there for me from the baseline. I could really get some good zip on the ball. I would probably prefer it with an 18-20 string pattern just to bring in a bit more control, but with a poly, good spin, nice pop, getting some nice angle because I get all that grip on the ball. Moving up to net, again, great comfort from that Zincore, it's just, and all their rackets, just really comfortable and good feel, you know. Silky smooth power delivery, never felt like I was going to overhit on the body. So on the shorter swings, it really fit my game well. On the longer swings, I would just prefer the feel of an 18-20, but that's just me. This is a nice racket.
When I first picked up the stick, took it down to court, I really liked the specs on it as I read them and took them on the RDC machine. And as I came down the court, really looking forward to hitting with it, and it surprised me a little bit as I felt it played a little bit heavier, a little more stable than I anticipated, and that's definitely not a bad thing. It took me probably 10 minutes or so to get the timing down, get the strokes going, but from the baseline, very solid on all strokes. Forehand, that open string pattern lent itself to give nice top spin, good control. I think Chris had mentioned some of the angles, which I really enjoyed hitting. But probably my favorite shot was the backhand slice. I liked how it drove through the ball, created a nice flat line drive with the slice, skidding low. Another aspect I liked was the serving. I felt the stability of the frame and the heft of it a little bit came through the ball nicely, created a heavy ball for the opponent. Up at net, very solid. I'm not much of a touch player, but what I liked about it was, again, the stability coming through the ball, creating a solid feel and solid volleys, being able to put the ball away. We're here with Jason Huang. Jay, judging by the specs alone, I'm guessing you like the stick. Why don't you give us your thoughts?
Well, like you, I had to adjust to it a little bit, the swing weight and the power that came with it. It felt a little sluggish to me at first, and I needed to get my timing down like you. And then once I did that, I found it was really powerful and really great access to spin. It surprised me because it's 11 and a half ounces and it had plenty of stability and plow through, much more so than I would expect. And it gave me power from all areas of the court. My serve, I thought, had more pop. My ground strokes, I got more free points out of that. It was just a little bit sluggish. And like Chris mentioned, the Zincore, just really comfortable, and I appreciated that because of my previous arm issues. But yeah, I thought it was a really, really solid stick and just had nice power, but just a little too sluggish for me.
We're here with Mark Boone. Mark, you're fresh off a knee injury. You've come back very strong as attested to our hit the other day. How does this racket work out for you?
One, a blessing to be not limping around the court. A lot of fun hitting with you the other day. Two, I really enjoyed this play test. I did not have the most amount of time to spend with it, but the time that I did spend with it was very valuable. Took it out for a hit last night, spent 3 hours with it, and it, like I said in my notes, if I had to come up with one term to describe the racket, I would say it was very versatile. 11 and a half ounce rackets in our system right now tend to run a little tip light, so it makes me want to add a little weight. There was enough weight out towards the tip with a 327 swing weight. For like the rest of the guys mentioned, it was very stable. It is a solid racket for good reason. It's a solid racket with the Zincore. So I didn't particularly have a favorite shot, but again, it was very versatile. I was able to maneuver it around. It was just heavy enough to get it in place for the volley, but not too heavy not to be able to get it there on time. Pace and spin, I had easy access to up the forehand, the serve, the backhand. And overall, just I don't really have any knocks for the racket at all. If I was gonna ask for the perfect combination, I might add a little bit of weight to the head. Overall, it was a very fun play test and a great racket.
Well, there you heard it from our play testers. Thanks for joining us for this edition of the Racquet Review. Check our website, tenniswarehouse.com, for more information. See you next time.